Ability to sense the organization culture is a high-value soft skill. It means you are aware of the informal organization, how things actually work here, and hence would be better equipped to navigate the politics within the company. This soft skill is part of empathy, awareness of your environment and the politics around you, which is an important component of emotional intelligence. Empathy includes other qualities such as understanding of others' feelings and sensing the atmosphere of the workplace. Number 7, vision and strategy. What is the vision of the company? Is it in line with your values? What is the strategy to achieve that vision? How is the strategy cascaded down to every employee? Is the strategy translated into everyday work in all job levels? Is there a transformation program underway? Company vision gives you a hint on whether your value system matches that of your company. For example, a bank's vision may be to maximize shareholders' return or to help customers to be successful. Which vision seems more convincing to you? The strategy reflects the well-being of the company and whether they are equipped to meet the ongoing challenges of market changes and competition. If you want to move towards a managerial role, your insight in these areas will be critical. If you are at a junior level, the company's vision will be an indicator of long-term prospects of growth or decline for the company. Either way, this is about developing your strategic mindset, a vital quality for long-term career success. Number 8, human resource strategy and policy. How are employees evaluated? What criteria is used for employee promotion? What types of training program is provided, usually for hard knowledge? What type of personal development program is available for personal growth, soft skills, hard skills, etc.? Your knowledge in these areas, especially seeking for personal development program, represents your attitude towards self-improvement. You will also need to look at your compensation and benefits package, along with how good performance is rewarded. Salary and bonus, stock options, restricted shares, medical benefits, retirement benefits, other type of benefits, for example, low interest loan, mortgage, subsidies for education, etc. These are elements of your total reward package, not just salary. And is an important consideration when you choose which company offers better compensation. If you are attracted by the higher pay from contract work, you need to take into account the total compensation package rather than judging solely by salary comparison. Information in this area is essential when you are making career decision in contemplation of major life events, for example, getting married, buying your own home, cars, having children, etc. If your goal is to buy your own property, usually a bank will offer low interest mortgage and staff loan. So you will need less down payment to be a homeowner. If you plan to have children, a stable job with a good medical coverage will be a favorable attraction. If you or your spouse wants to go on contract work or start a business, the other half having a permanent job with good benefits would be ideal. During an interview for a large company, if you are asked, "Why do you want to work with us?" these are good, honest responses you can use to show your long-term interest. There's a simple fact. Companies who recruit permanent employees don't want frequent turnover. More importantly, companies do want to invest in the development of their talented or the permanent employees as part of their management successions plan. Apparently, they would choose those who demonstrate long-term interest with the company. Number 9, work arrangement. Are flexible hours allowed and encouraged? Is remote working supported and encouraged? Supporting flexible work patterns is an indication that the company is aware of the preference of younger generations. If a company had adjusted their HR policy and procedures to make this happen, it means They treasure young talents and go all the way to attract and retain them. This, in turn, implies the company have started the transformation to adapt to the changing demographics and future trend of business, a promising sign of a good company. Many see flexible work arrangements as an element of work-life balance. When you are job seeking, on top of showing your appreciation of work-life balance, and need to polish up your readiness in a number of ways. Your adaptability, flexi hour, may mean you can take time off any hour of the day when you are not busy or when you finished all the work. You can start playing. It often means you may be expected to stay late or get up early for meetings or on call to tackle urgent issues. You need to prepare examples to your interviewer to show you can adapt to these types of lifestyles. Your discipline, especially if you are allowed to work remotely, usually from home, your boss won't be able to check on your start or end time. You will also need to be disciplined to manage many security concerns. For example, avoid inappropriate use of your company laptop, securely handle sensitive information, prevent getting infected by viruses from your personal USB drive, or just being careless and lose or damage your company equipment. In short, from the employer's perspective, flexible work arrangements are about cost efficiency, less office space, less overtime pay, while improving work-life balance for employees. If you are interviewing for a company with this type of arrangement, you need to show how you can fit in their strategy. Number 10, the people. You can learn a lot from the people at work, whether they are good or bad bosses, friendly or hostile colleagues, difficult customers, approachable or arrogant executives. This is the best opportunity to practice your soft skills. If you have a good boss, you can learn from their leadership skills. If your boss is bad, you learn the negative side of leadership, that is, what to avoid. When you describe this observation in an interview, it will be a convincing story of your leadership potential. Typically, leadership skills you can observe may include motivation, communication, strategic thinking, people development, team building. As an example, when your interviewer asks you why you decided to leave your current job, you may say that your boss didn't teach you anything and blamed any failures on his team. This actually reflects that you have a victim mindset. If you say that you are looking for leadership that develops people and succeeds or fails as a team, and that your current boss is not offering you this, you come out as a positive and career-minded candidate. You seek for better leadership rather than running away from bad leadership. Teamwork is a typical interview question. How you solve problems with your team or meet tight deadlines while having a laid-back team member with a giant ego who prefers to argue rather than cooperate are scenarios the interviewers want to observe. You package your experience against the key success elements of teamwork to paint the story of how you have been a great team player. Skills involved as a team player would be planning, collaboration, coordination, social skills, communication, influencing and persuasion in decision making, problem solving, and conflict management. If you have a bad team, it is actually a good opportunity for you to demonstrate how you manage to work with difficult people or as a part of a dysfunctional team. You don't need to twist a failed project into a successful story. You can describe what you have tried, empathize with your difficult colleagues to see from his or her perspective in trying to reach consensus. Identify common goals and create a win-win situation instead of playing blame games. In short, both good or bad experience in your current job can be painted as a positive learning opportunity. Example, in your next interview, Keep in mind, no employer would want blame culture and victim mindset in their team. As a matter of fact, the same principle applies to school projects. Students who have zero work experience can also tune their story in the same way. A caution, during your interview, you need to be very clear on these concepts. Otherwise, your interviewer will see you as using the buzzwords without knowing what they mean. Here are some examples. Question, give me an example how you tackle a problem with your team. Bad answer is, there was a tight deadline and increased scope. We all worked overtime to get it done. And the good answer is, there was a tight deadline and increased scope. We distributed the unplanned work according to the strengths of each member and we managed to complete the work on time without overtime. Question, how did you make a decision as a team? A bad answer is, we voted. And the good answer is, we discussed each other's opinion and viewpoint and then evaluate them against the objectives of the project to derive the conclusion. Question, do you have a team member who is difficult to work with? How did you deal with him? Bad answer is, I kept my contact with him to a minimum. All communications were done in black and white to leave a track record of his problem behavior. And the good answer could be, I had a candid conversation with him to agree what our differences were. We set our shared goals and determined how we would work together, as well as setting boundaries on where we would leave each other alone. It's worth your time to read some books in this area. I recommend the following: Working with Difficult People, Handling the 10 Types of Problem People Without Losing Your Mind by Emmy Cooper Hakim and Muriel Solomon. The 5 Dysfunctions of a Team, A Leadership Fable by Patrick Lencioni, and 360 Degree Leadership by John Maxwell. Summary: Don't just do your job. By going beyond your day job to observe and learn, you can make the most of your workplace to build up your resume and competencies for your career advancement. Your education and your job will give you the hard knowledge which serves as the foundation of your employment. Your interview, in particular HR and the AI software that scans your resume, will be very well versed with these buzzwords. These buzzwords may give you a higher chance of getting an interview. Quoting compelling example from your experience during an interview will help you to get the job. To be successful in your job, you need to actually learn and apply these competencies. That will be a lifelong endeavor of learning. So the 10 things that you can possibly learn at your workplace and advance in your career. Best wishes. Thank you.